Today is the last day, and today we will cover all the queries of all the members. So I welcome CA Namman Srimal, CA Chaitanya Maheshwari on this platform of What Next Team and CAs of Mumbai. So friends, we are coming with a few more webinar series. One is on IBPC and one is on Companies Act. And tomorrow we are having two special webinars. So I request Virag to just give an introduction and as well as give a brief detail of tomorrow's webinar. Virag bhai.
Yes. Thank you, Abhishek. Welcome, Naman bhai. Welcome, Chaitanya ji. Tomorrow we have two interesting webinars. One is on finance and opportunity for finance professionals in this changing paradigm. It's by CA Robin Banerjee. It's one of the very good speaker. So take the benefit of that webinar as well. And one more is for spiritual wellness. Guruma is taking one session that she is a very well-known and motivational speaker also, life changer basically. And she has a nutrition and also they have an Ayurvedic center at near Nasik. So she is handling entire that wellness center as well. And we in that session we have a Sunil Patolia sir also, our past chairman of WRC. So and this is a free seminar for all, so kindly take that benefit as well. And today is the last day for our this international tax practice, how we can start that from scratch. So we have a wonderful session of all 3 days and today is the last day. Take the benefit. Naman bhai is always with us, Chaitanya ji always with us. Any query in future as well, they are always with us virtually. So take the benefit. And with this word, without wasting much of your time, would like to request Naman ji to start the session. Naman bhai, I already shared the screen as well. So kindly start the session.
Is the screen available, visible?
Sorry. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. So, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome back to the fourth day and the penultimate day of this interesting four-day course, International Taxation. And, you know, over the last 3 days, we have pondered upon some of the basics, some little advanced concepts, and basically the whole idea was to be on concepts and, you know, to ignite that, yes, international taxation practice can be worked out from anywhere, and small and medium practitioners can also, you know, do the international taxation.
Still not visible.
Sorry, screen is not visible.
Naman bhai, your screen is still not visible.
Okay,
screen,
just a second.
If it is not visible.
Okay, let me. It should ideally be, I don't know, just a second. Now it is visible?
Not yet.
Okay. I don't know what problem is this. Just a second. It's visible now?
Yeah, visible.
So can you see the first slide? Chaitanya, visible?
Yes, visible.
Okay,
we can see first.
Okay, thank you. So, you know, the whole intention of this seminar was that to ignite the basic fundas of international taxation. And yes, you know, all of us can practice into that. That was the sole aim. And the kind of, you know, messages and emails and, you know, on messages on LinkedIn and other platforms I have got, fully shows my faith, yes, that everybody can practice on this platform and everybody can really, really, you know, basically work out on these international taxation practice. So thank you all for sending all those, you know, mails and requests and, you know, and actually asking such wonderful queries, you know. So many, many thanks to all of you. For this presentation, you know, I want to really thank my team to prepare such presentation, and the whole idea was there. So Naman and from Harshita from my team have prepared this presentation. So many, many thanks to them. So let's, what's the agenda of the day? It's the last day, you know. The agenda of the day is that I'll tell you how a search is done. And use a Provace-based, you know, software, which is one of the software which can be used. Let's say it will take around 20 to 30 minutes. Next 30 minutes, Chaitanya will take the advanced query, advanced, you know, transfer pricing concepts. So he'll cover that. And last 1 hour, we have kept completely for ask, you know, replying to your queries. So I have seen that a lot of queries were still pending. These queries can be concepts also. These queries can be questions also specific. And these queries can be something more like that, how to start the practice and any guidance on that front also. So any questions you can, you know, shoot in the last 1 hour, and, you know, we'll try to answer most of them. All of them is not a possibility because there are sometimes very, very critical things and sometimes not everything can be checked. So we'll try to answer maximum in the last 1 hour. Okay, so thank you all for joining in, you know, last 3 days of grilling international taxation discussion, and still you are here. So, you know, thank you for coming. So first of all, the first topic is that how do you actually decide what kind of softwares are there So what kind of softwares are there in the market? Okay, and how do you decide which one is the best? Okay, I say it, you decide it in the manner that you decide your these platforms, OTT platforms, Netflix hai, Prime Video hai, Disney Hotstar hai, ye sare hum log dekhte hain, aur kisi ko kya pasand aata hai, kisi ko kya pasand aata hai. Okay, so bahut sare logo ko bahut sari cheeze पसंद आती है अलग अलग, एंड देट कुड बी डिफरेंट डिफरेंट क्राइटेरिया फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वॉट इज बेनिफिशियल ओवर वर्ल्ड. तो दिस कुड बी अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट आई लाइक नेटफ्लिक्स बट चैतन्य भाई लाइक प्राइम वीडियो. देर कुड बी डिफरेंट डिफरेंट पॉसिबिलिटी. सो द वे यू डिसाइड योर ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म इज द वे यू डिसाइड विच सॉफ्टवेयर. आई जस्ट डिलीबरेटली यू नो इन नेक्स्ट 5 मिनट्स टेल यू विच आर द सॉफ्टवेयर अवेलेबल, वॉट आर द पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव अकॉर्डिंग टू मी. दिस कुड वेरी एक्चुअली. ओके, so first software is a Provace software, Provace IQ it is called. Okay, it is developed by Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. CMIE is one of the biggest statistical organization in the country, and many of the data which come, you know, come from CMIE. You will see a lot of them references given in the newspaper. You know, it has around 51,000 companies database. Okay, it's a very, very user friendly. This is personally my favorite. Okay, because, or just because I've been using this for last 10 years. Okay, so this is Provace IQ. The negative side of it is that it is costly. It is costlier than the other platforms available, other software available, and annual reports and all can be downloaded. I will run through the search process through this Provace IQ only. Okay, as of now. Next is Capital Line TP. I think Chaitanya Bhai uses that. Okay, and this is one. So Provace and Capital Line are one of the oldest softwares available. Okay, around 35,000 companies. Okay, vast coverage of industry, and capitalize is something very good for a person who is into stock market also. Okay, because it has a very good stock ticker and everything. When, you know, good 7-8 years back I used to use it, then Capital Line, you know, it's a very good concept. So you can earn, or I don't know, lose maybe money by that manner also. So Capital Line is good, and you can download annual report. There's a website is also given over there. The third one is the newest kid on the block, ASTP. So ASTP was practically, so if you see, Provace and Capital Line have now come out with their version of, they would say, as a transfer pricing software. But earlier they were only research software or a statistical software, or let's say something for stock markets and everything. So Proves, you will find a lot of R&D people using Proves. Capital Line, you will find a lot of stock market people using Capital Line. But good part about Capital Line is that it has, normally it has some collaboration with the institute, so you get it in a very, very cheap price also. ASTP is the newest kid on the block, and this was specifically designed for transfer pricing. Okay, so when it is specifically designed for transfer pricing, and I have used this for 2-3 years also, you know, when sometimes clients are there, they demand searches from free software to software, so we use it. Okay, so this is very good, you know, very interactive, very customizable, and the very good flow is there. Again, this is my reading. Okay, and the best part of ASTP is also that it is available in some small packages also, like for 3 months, 1 month, 6 months, or in a year. So this is very, very interesting software. So these are the three softwares. ये तीन software है जो कि primarily use होते हैं for basically transfer pricing. जो हमने कल समझ रहे थे कि हमको company कैसे ढूंढनी है, what are the companies we will find. वो कंपनी हम इस सॉफ्टवेयर के थ्रू फाइंड करते हैं. नाउ हाउ एन इफेक्टिव सर्च इज कंडक्टेड. ओके, कैसे एक सर्च कंडक्ट करी जाती है? आप लोगों ने तीन दिन से यू नो यू हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग एंड यू नो सेशंस हैव बीन अटेंडिंग. आई ऑलवेज स्टार्ट विद एन एग्जांपल एंड आई कैरी दैट एग्जांपल ऑल थ्रू माय प्रेजेंटेशन. ओके, एंड हियर आल्सो इज एन एग्जांपल, एंड दिस एग्जांपल इज इट्स शॉपिंग टाइम. सब लोग लॉकडाउन में बैठे हैं. ओके, एंड लॉकडाउन में जब आप बैठे हो तो सबसे ज्यादा याद आ रही है कि यार हम कितनी शॉपिंग करते थे. आई विल रिविजिट यू टू द शॉपिंग डेज एंड द वे शॉपिंग इज डन. ओके, एग्जैक्टली इज द सेम वे यू विल कंडक्ट योर ट्रांसफर प्राइसिंग सर्च. इट इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम मैनर. ओके, एंड वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड शॉपिंग, विच ऑल ऑफ अस यू डू, आई डोंट थिंक सो यू कैन यू नो एवर फॉरगेट हाउ एन इफेक्टिव सर्च इज डन. तो शॉपिंग के लिए आप क्या करते हैं? ओके, ऐसा नहीं है कि सडनली आप एकदम से उठ के चले गए एंड यू गो टू द मॉल एंड यू बाय स्टफ. देयर इज अ प्रोसेस बिहाइंड अ शॉपिंग. ओके, फर्स्ट यू डिसाइड एट व्हेन यू आर एट होम, यू डिसाइड दैट आई वांट दिस स्टफ. दिस इज यू नो आई वांट टू गो टू दैट पार्टी, सो आई वांट दिस. लेट्स आई वांट अ टी-शर्ट और आई वांट द स्नीकर्स और आई वांट व्हाटएवर. सो यू डिसाइड, यू मेक अ लिस्ट. ओके, ठीक है. वंस यू मेक अ लिस्ट, यू गो आउट एंड गो फॉर द मॉल. Okay, or any other store. Once you enter into the store, first thing what you do, you just don't go and pick up one shirt. Okay, let's say you are buying a shirt, you just go, don't go over there and pick up one shirt. What you do is basically you will pick up 5, 7, 10 shirts randomly which you feel like. Okay, without seeing anything. Okay, yaar ye theek lag raha hai, ye bhi le lo. Ye theek lag raha hai, ye bhi le lo. Everything, you know, this is a Van Heusen brand, this is a Allen Solly, this is cottons, this is whatever, and you take up. Okay, that's the first thing you do into shopping. Okay, post that the next thing which you always do is that you will see, acha yaar ye kaam ka nahi hai, you will apply some filters. You apply some filters and you say, okay, this price is not, you know, I don't want to pay so much. Oh, I don't want this brand. Okay, I don't want this size, and you apply some filters. Okay, next, before even going to try it out, you always, you know, try it out, just pick it up ki aapko shoulder pe sahi aa raha hai kya, whatever be it, you just try and do that. Uske baad aap jaake trial room mein jaate ho aur trial room mein se ek ek ko select karke, post going to the trial room, then whatever is fine for you, you buy. And that is the way, you know, just carry it through when I'm giving you examples later. That is the way an effective search is conducted, and you will, you know, see this example going through my complete slide for next 30 minutes. Okay, so let's start from a practical case. What is the background of the case? Ek software company hai jo ki provide karti hai apni software development services apni assessing associate enterprises ko foreign ke andar. Okay, so this software company provides software development services to its associate enterprise in US. Okay, transaction, you know, it is of provision of software development services. Tested party, हमको किसका margin test करना है? Which company? हमको देखना है कि हमारी जो company है, Indian company, क्या वो दूसरी software company से better profit कमाती है? Does it earn better profit than the other competitors in the market, does it earn? Okay, we want to see that. Okay, या फिर कम कमाती है तो हम टेस्टेड पार्टी देख रहे हैं कि क्या हम बेटर हो रहे हैं, हम हमारा जो हम प्राइसिंग कर रहे हैं इट इज गुड और नॉट, ये हमको चेक करना है. तो टेस्टेड पार्टी इज आवर ओन असेसिंग कंपनी. देन वी गो ऑन सिलेक्शन ऑफ मेथड. कल आपको बताया था एक एक मेथड को सिलेक्ट करना है. तो यू कांट सेलेक्ट कब बिकॉज यू डोंट प्रोवाइड सर्विसेज टू एनी वन एंड यू डोंट हैव एनी एक्सटर्नल डेटा अवेलेबल. तो कब हम जब भी लगा सकते हैं जब हम सिमिलर ट्रांजैक्शन किसी और के साथ करते हैं या एक्सटर्नल डेटा कोई अवेलेबल होता है तो हम कब लगा सकते हैं यहाँ पे कोई कब है नहीं. आरपीएम वी आर नॉट अ ट्रेडर और अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर सो आरपीएम कैन नॉट बी अप्लाइड. पीपीएम कैन बी अप्लाइड बिकॉज वी आर डूइंग अ कॉस्ट प्लस मार्जिन. बट क्या होता है जिस तरीके से हमारे इंडियन फाइनेंशियल्स आज के रोज में डिजाइंड है ओके उसमें वो कहीं भी ग्रॉस प्रॉफिट नहीं मांगता. तो समटाइम्स वी यूज दिस प्ली टू से नो सीपीएम कांट बी डन. प्रॉफिट स्प्लिट नहीं कर सकते बिकॉज दोनों के अलग हैं. करा जा सकता है बट प्रॉफिट स्प्लिट जनरली यूज होता है जहां पे इंटेंजिबल इन्वॉल्व होते हैं ओके. एंड देन यू लेफ्ट विद तेरा ना मेरा मेथड कि यार चलो अपन टोटल प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी देख लेते हैं. इफ माय प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी इज फाइन देन आई एम अर्निंग मोर मार्जिन. इफ आई एम अर्निंग मोर मार्जिन देन द अदर पीपल इन द कंट्री हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग सेम और सिमिलर सर्विसेज okay, I am fine. So we will start doing the, you know, we will see TNNM method, how it is applicable. This is what a ProWays looks like. Okay. And remember, you have already decided which, what kind of clothes you required in a FAR analysis. So you have decided ki mujhe kya kharidna hai, meri aisi company hai, mujhe aisa chahiye. You have stepped out, you have entered into this mall, which is ProWays. Okay, and now you will start accumulating all your shirts. Okay, ek ek karke aap shirts ikattha karna chalu karenge. So I'll just give you a brief background. Sare software ek jaise hi dikhte hai, mota aage piche thoda bahut. I'll just give you an example of how ProWays looks. So you want software. So ye ProWays dikhta hai yahan pe kuch iske output pe ye panes hai alag. First thing is you will start select companies in predefined set. Kyunki bahut sare predefined set hote hain. Manufacturing, mining, electricity. You go in over here and you type in software and then you press search. Okay. So you go over, you say software, you search it over, you will see a tick coming over here and you tick it over. Computer software. Okay. So first aapne ek jagah gaye aur aapne itni sari shirts le li computer software se related. और फिर क्या करना है आपको, आपको देखना है कि यहाँ पे ऑल कंपनीज पूरे मॉल में जो जो भी आपको सॉफ्ट शर्ट्स अवेलेबल है सब में से जो आपको इंटरेस्टिंग शर्ट्स लगती हैं आपको एक बार आपने पिकअप कर ली ऑल कंपनीज एंड यू से ऐड टू करंट ओएससी. ओएससी इज आउटपुट शीट ओके. दिस इज अ ProWays डेफिनेशन आई एम यूजिंग एचटीपी एंड कैपिटल लाइन वी आर लीविंग इट फॉर अ व्हाइल. सो दिस इज ऐड टू करंट ओएससी. अब क्या होगा नेक्स्ट स्टेप के अंदर जितनी भी कंपनीज कंप्यूटर सॉफ्टवेयर से लिंक होगी आउट ऑफ दो 50,000 कंपनी वो एक सेट में आ जाएगी. यहाँ पे न्यू आउटपुट में क्लिक करेंगे तो वो आउटपुट आ जाएगा. सो व्हेनेवर यू क्लिक ऑन अ न्यू आउटपुट you will get it okay. But there are different places in the mall where you go. So you will go to another counter also. You will go to counter now which is main product and service. So aise kai bar hoti hai we don't get exactly, you know, software to bahut broad field hai. You will get hundreds of data but sometimes there are something like a toilet paper you will not get over here. ठीक है. सो यू विल गो इन टू मेन प्रोडक्ट एंड सर्विस एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट. सो सॉफ्टवेयर सर्विस आई एम अगेन फाइंडिंग आउट. यू गो टू डिफरेंट काउंटर इन द मॉल एंड यू पिक अप मोर 3-4 शर्ट्स ओके. देन यू अगेन प्रेस सॉफ्टवेयर सर्विसेज एंड यू से ऐड टू करंट ओएससी. यू कीप एडिंग. सो दिस इज द ProWays क्लासिफिकेशन ओवर देयर एंड दिस इज द एनआईसी क्लासिफिकेशन. इफ यू कैन सी द एरो दिस इज द एनआईसी क्लासिफिकेशन. सो व्हेन वी फाइल आरओसी रिटर्न वी फाइल ओवर देयर एनआईसी क्लासिफिकेशन. The ProWays data picks up it on the NIC classification. So you can search over here also. You can search over here also. And you say add to current OSC. Okay. Now this again keep on getting added. But you are still not satisfied. Shopping can never be, you know, make you satisfied. So what do? You move ahead. Then you again select, you know, by some other method. There is another mainframe. So you go to another stall. And you again select. Okay. Then there is another stall, there is another counter, you again go query on name. Now this is very interesting query. You know, this is something like when you file in your ROC return and when you file audit report and everything, and let's say in your financial statement, you have normally you have accounting policies where you give a history of the company. So whatever you write in your history of the companies, it gets selected over there. Okay. And aap yahan pe software service dikhoge to yahan pe let's say selected product 24 aa gaye and 24 mein se you have selected whatever be it and you can keep adding you know. So and one thing I just want to clarify, I am explaining you the search via Provis, but exactly Provis kaise run karta hai which the Provis person can better tell you. So I'm just understanding kis tarah se hum log addition karte hain. Okay, so this is the way it is done. Then उसके बाद आप क्या करते हो, नाउ ऑल द एडिशन हैज बीन डन, सो वॉट एवर बी द एडिशन हैज बीन डन एंड यू आर ऑन अ हीप ऑफ क्लोथ्स, आपने सारे क्लोथ्स इकट्ठे कर लिए, सारी कंपनी एक एक करके सॉफ्टवेयर सर्च सॉफ्टवेयर करके जितना भी प्रोग्रेस में सॉफ्टवेयर रिलेटेड डेटा है, सॉफ्टवेयर रिलेटेड कंपनी है, वो सारी कंपनीज आपने इकट्ठी कर ली. ओके एंड ये बैकग्राउंड में अपने आप इकट्ठी होती जा रही है. ओके एंड नाउ यू विल ट्राई सम फिल्टरिंग. यार यू मे नॉट लाइक द प्राइस, यू मे नॉट लाइक द ब्रांड, यू मे नॉट लाइक सम आपने एक बार तो शर्ट ले ली बट आपके साइज की नहीं आई. ओके एंड देयर कुड बी डिफरेंट वेराइटी वेयर यू विल नॉट लाइक. सो नाउ यू आर स्टार्टिंग फिल्टरिंग एंड दिस इज वेयर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ यू नो फिल्टरिंग विल कम. एंड इसके लिए आपका फार बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है, हु आर यू, उसी के हिसाब से आप फिल्टरिंग करते हो. तो आप अपने फार के हिसाब से यहाँ पे फिल्टरिंग करते हो, बट समर बेसिक कॉमन फिल्टर्स. ओके समर बेसिक कॉमन फिल्टर्स विच आर अप्लाइड एवरीवेयर. तो यस्टरडे वी सॉ लास्ट 3 years डेटा आर अलाउड. सो व्हाट आई हैव डन इन अ क्वेरी ओवर देयर, यहाँ पे आप क्वेरी देखेंगे 2017 मार्च, 2018 मार्च एंड 2019 मार्च. ये क्वेरी पूरी नहीं दिख रही है but it says 2017 March, 2018 March, 2019 March. इसमें से जो भी साल के relevant, you know, equal to 2 or 3 years data है, okay, वो आप निकाल दो. तो अभी पिछली साइड में क्या हुआ था, what happened in the last slide was till there was a 1371 companies total आ गई, you got 1371 shirts. ठीक है, from the mall, you are really greedy, you want everything on the mall, you got 1317 company. But the moment you applied this filter of year, okay, and you sent, okay, send, and see, yahan pe kya karoge, yahan pe there is one difference. Yahan pe instead of all companies, you will see companies in current OSC because your search in the complete mall is now over. Only now from this 1351 companies, you want that companies in current OSC, unhi pe ye filter lage. Ab aap unko unhi shirts pe dikhoge, aap aur dusri shirts pe nahi jaoge. Okay, so you will see, you will apply this, okay, and now 523 company, after you apply 523 companies would be selected. Then you go next, then you want, I don't want dormant companies, there is a filter of ownership classification. Okay, so there is a filter of ownership classification over there, you can see. Okay, you don't want dormant because dormant price is not a correct price. Government may have different kind of its own pricing mechanism, its own way to price stuff. Okay, so you only want, you selected private sector. Okay, you only want selected as a private sector, and then you again say send to new OSC, and remember you say companies in current OSC. So companies and uni companies current. So last slide ke andar there were. Last slide mein 523 companies were there. Now 4 companies have been rejected and 519 companies are retained after applying this government filter. Next filter is that you don't want very chotu companies. There are some companies which are listed and they come over here. There are some private companies which come over there, which have a turnover of let's say 10 lakhs, 5 lakhs. You don't want because you it's not comparable to you. So you have a sales filter now. So what do you do? यहां पे आपने सेल्स का फिल्टर लगाया, ओवरहेड सेल्स, एंड यू से लेस देन 1 करोड़. ओके सो यू से लेस देन 1 करोड़ जिसकी सेल है वो सारे के सारे हट जाए. So yahan pe hai standalone financial statement mein you have written one, all the units are in crore. Okay, so less than 1 crore आपने जो भी किया annual financial statement से ये sales पे आपने filter लगा दिया और इस filter लगाने के बाद you again said. तो अभी क्या हुआ last time 519 companies आई थी, now you are restricted to 412 companies because those 100 and whatever companies, 17 companies, 107 companies sales were less than 1 crore. So sales were less than 1 crore. अब ये भी हट गया. ऐसे हम और filter लगा रहे हैं. You know, we don't want networks ki koi negative networks wali company hai. So now 395 companies. We don't want ki ekdam lower profitability wali company hai. Humne wo bhi hata diya. So now it is 339 companies. This related party transaction is a very, very important filter and many times people forget to apply that. Any company which has more than 25% related party transaction, we don't want that. Because if it itself has a related party transaction of more than 25%, its own margin may not be correct. वो खुद के margin भी गलत हो सकते हैं. So this is a very very important and most of the times जब भी हमारे पास कोई TP study लेकर आता है, कई बार वो ये filter लगाता ही नहीं है. So you don't want related party transaction. थोड़े वो सब में होंगे. There will be director remuneration, there will be rent, but a 25 or a 20% filter is the most acceptable filter. So you apply at 25% se jyada related party companies hui na, to bhai hata dena. So from 339 companies, you go to 125 companies. Baki sab mein more than 25% related party transactions hai. Okay, so you are now restricted. Aapki jo heap ho rahi hai, which started with around 1300 companies, wo dheere 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 kam ho rahi hai. You have applied all your general filters. Sare general filters ki I'll check the brand, I'll check the price, I'll check it is not old, I'll check it is not old fashioned, whatever be it. Ye sari general filtering ho gayi. But now you will enter into specific filter jiske liye aapne FAR kiya tha. Okay, so let's say you wanted a dress for a party. Okay, so out of this 125 dresses you will now see your party ke liye kaun si theek lagegi. Ek baar yun hi karke khade hoke dekh lete party ke liye kaun si theek lagegi. So you apply specific filter. In our case, because it is a software company, we have applied a filter jo humne kal FAR mein dekha tha, and that is the importance of FAR. I am what I am. Okay, so a software company which have a employee cost more than 60%. So what I do, I see employee cost more than 60%, mujhe to wohi company chahiye. And now this is a specific filter. Mujhe party ke liye kapde chahiye, mujhe स्पोर्ट्स के लिए कपड़े चाहिए. आई वॉन्ट यू नो क्लोथ अकॉर्डिंग टू द थिंग्स आई वॉन्ट रिक्वायर. सो दैट इज वाई यू नाउ फिल्टर टू यू स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1300, यू गॉट रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू 36 कंपनीज. ओके, फ्रॉम 1300 टू 36 कंपनीज यू आर रिस्ट्रिक्टेड. फर्स्ट यू एडेड, देन यू अप्लाई जनरल फिल्टर, देन यू अप्लाई स्पेसिफिक फिल्टर. लेकिन अभी भी यू आर नॉट बाइंग एवरीथिंग. ओके, नाउ वंस दैट 36 कंपनीज कम अप, no, this is the way data can be saved. Okay, so over here you can save the data as a text, as a user set, as an Excel. So see, now company 36 are there and list of companies are there. Okay, and this list of companies come out of every step. A recommendation to everyone, and I tell my team always that whatever is there, you keep at every stage, you keep saving the data, because as I explained to you yesterday, trial and error pe chalta hai, ek baar mein nahi hota hai. So you will never know कहाँ पे गलत हुआ है. So every time you keep saving it as, you can save it as Excel, you can save it as user set. The benefit of saving at user set is that you can start working from that point of time. You don't have to start from zero again. Okay? So this is save as user set, save as Excel. ऐसा data निकल जाता है जिसको आप save कर लेते हो. Now at this point of time, we save it as an Excel. हम लोग इसको Excel के अंदर save कर लेते हैं यहाँ पे. And now it is time to go into the fitting room. हम लोग trial room में जा रहे हैं. Okay? This is the trial room. Accept reject matrix. And this is one of the very very critical function. Trial room में आप खाली देख के नहीं करते, आप एक एक कपड़े को try करते हो. You try out every cup. So what we do? Let's say 36 companies यहाँ पे आई थी. First company is A Software Export Limited. what I will do is that I will go to ACE website, do a Google search. It will throw up a website. I will go and see the business description. Ye kya provide karta hai. So I am trying it out in a fitting room. Okay. And I say, okay, this is document management, digital publishing. So it was looking good when I just saw that. Okay. But when I'm trying, it is not looking at all good. Okay. So this isn't digital publishing, data conversion. No. This is not a software company. Okay. Similarly, it's a business technology solution company and all that stuff. This is not a software company. तो हम हर एक चीज को ट्राई करते हैं एंड देन ट्राई करने के बाद और ट्राई कैसे करते हैं ये मैं इसको आपको आगे भी बताता हूं. दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी यू नो प्रोसेस वेयर वेयर द मैक्सिमम टाइम इज गिवन. ओके सो वी गो टू गूगल, वी गो ओवर देयर, कंपनी का नाम आता है, उसके बाद हम उसकी वेबसाइट पे जाते हैं, फिर वहां से अबाउट अस निकालते हैं. एंड समटाइम्स दिस इज नाउ 36 कंपनीज वी हैव डन Google search for 500, 700, 800 companies because there is no further filtration which is applicable. And it takes long time. It takes a long time. You know, all the articles, staff, everybody gets harrowed. Okay. And sab thak jate. Even Google sometimes asks proof that you are a robot because you are doing so many searches. Okay. And every site has to be seen minutely. And this is to be prepared. So documentation is very important. You have to see what the documentation is there. Reject. Isme acceptance wala nahi dikh raha hai. And you see kis karan se reject hua. There could be many reasons. Functionally different. Okay. I don't like. Ek bar pehenne ke baad achha nahi laga. Okay. There could be reason. Insufficient data. Mujhe size hi nahi aaya dekhne ke baad. Okay. Every brand has a different size. So it is the data is not available. Okay. There could be many more reasons. The company is completely different and all. So you prepare and uske baad finally aap last companies ke andar aate ho, which in this scenario this is the complete summary you make. So you keep on adding, okay, and 1371 one big heap is of clothes are there. Then you apply common filter, you keep on filtering. Then you apply specific filter, okay, and then you try 36 companies. Sorry, हमने try करी, उसमें से 28 were not fit, and 8 outfit fit us exactly, and we got those 8 outfit, and we bought those 8 outfit, okay. So this is the whole way of searching through any software you use. You use HTTP, you use Probase, you use CapitalLine. That's the way you search it. So if you like the way example was presented, okay, it was shown, please give in your comments in the chat box. I will be very happy to receive the comment. If you don't like, then also give your comment. But if you like the way it was presented, please give your comments on the same. So this is a very, very tedious process. This is a difficult process. It's a long process. Okay. And it takes a long time. And that is why to conduct a transfer pricing study report, you need to charge a good amount because this process takes time. Okay. This process takes a lot of time, but it can be done. And this can be understood in this manner. Now what happens? Once you are done with your study, and there is this last now you want to actually check margin kaisa hai. So let's say 16 17 18 and 17 18 ki aap TP study bana rahe ho, so you see sales and all that stuff, ek company ki, this was the final company selected. Okay, I'll move a little fast. This was the final 8 companies selected, which we selected were of software. Then what we do for each and every company, we there is some disturbance from some audio. I don't know which one is that. So if somebody can mute that. Okay. So this let's say Kyle's information. You go to the 16, 17, 18 financials. You find out and you make the margin accordingly. That this is the margin and all these margins are over there. And your lower percentile, as we understood last time, and your higher percentile that is there, and the median is there 14.065. Once उसके बाद आप देखोगे कि आपका ऐसी कंपनी का 12.6 आ रहा है, and range for comparable company is this 1.5 to 18.51, and therefore transaction with associate enterprise can be considered at a arm's length. Okay, so this is the way, you know, basically I would say a search process is conducted. First you keep on adding, then you keep on filtering, then you keep on further filtering, then you go to their websites. After websites, you find out, thankfully, if the numbers are 20, 20, 50, 56, fine. Okay, but number are huge, you can't do anything. You find out, and you find out which company suits you. And then once you find out, you take out their, and this data is also available from software. Okay, kitni income hai. So you don't have to go to ROC and anything. Okay, all the data is available over here. Then you make a sheet. This is our form format. This can be anything. This is our form format. You can use anything. Okay. And then once you see, you apply a weighted average and you see what is the median. And once you see the median, and then you know the range, and then you apply this. So this is the way it is done. These are some of the common filter which we in our form are used. Again, as I'm saying, this can be anything. These are few of the specific filter. And now I have a test for you. Next 5 minutes, test. Okay. So देखो common filter everybody applies. Government companies नहीं चाहिए, sales turnover, profit before tax positive होना चाहिए, related profit, party transaction हटने चाहिए. Now this is a test for you. The FAR is like that. Indian company manufactures specific spare part used in car. 80% of the sale are made to A in USA. The method applied to benchmark is transaction is TNM. Now, like in a software company, we applied 60% employee cost as a specific filter. In this case, what will be applied? Can you answer? In this case, what will be applied as a specific filter? Production cost, manufacturing company. Car manufacturer, export oriented, very good. Automobile industry, purchase of raw material, very good. Asset intensive, very wow. You're excellent people. Just in one day, you grabbed everything. You know, one day you grabbed everything over there. Okay. So, next slide. You may apply these filters. There can be many more. Like selected companies having high manufacturing sales to total sales. So, manufacturing sales to total sales, high only. You may have high export sales to total sales, okay, because 80% are export, so you can have high export sales to total sales. You can have company which has high raw material expenses, because a manufacturing company will generally have a high raw material. Okay, what we learned in FAR yesterday, okay, apply all that knowledge, and that is why I'm telling you the FAR is the most critical part of transfer pricing study report. It's the most critical part. So once you know it's a manufacturing company which exports, okay, you can apply these three filters. A common mistake is there. You may apply ki 80% sale related party ki honi chahiye. 80% sale related party ki honi chahiye. No, don't apply that, because agar kisi ki 80% sales hui, so you may never know whether they are doing in the right margin or not. Okay, so if there are high related party transaction, please remove that. And again, I'm stressing on the point that these are the way we do it. It could be substantially different the way somebody else do a transfer pricing study report. Okay. Last question. Indian company is a subsidiary of a multinational company which trades in FMCG product. The Indian company purchased goods from associate enterprise in USA and sell it to unrelated parties in India. Obviously, it is fine. It looks like a trader and a distributor. Therefore, the method applied to benchmark the transaction is RPM. You can apply the RPM method. Ab isme kya kaun se characteristics, kaun kaun se specific filter lagaoge? Just let me know. In this scenario, what filter should be applied? It's a distributor company. It's a trading company which purchases goods from a foreign company and sells in India. Very good. Import cost high, 100% import. FMCG, Finish. Very good. Trading sales less than greater than 75. Yes, Prasanna. Very good. Important trading, Govind. Yes. Trading company, Mahendra. Praveen. Very good. Wow. No, purchase of finished goods, Sachet. Yes. No manufacturing expense. Very good, Shivangi. Darshan. Yes. Okay. So, yes, most of you got it very, very, you know, in a correct manner. So, you will say, okay, select companies having high trading sales. Okay. Foreign purchase, you know, when in your financial statement you say कि हमने foreign पे कितना FOB पे कितना purchase किया है, CIF value पे, whatever you do, ये सारा data Provis उठाता है, या Formulometer, any software उठाता है. We decided कि trading company it can have a low fixed asset. Okay, so yes, select company having low fixed asset, that would be a trading company. Having high foreign purchases, having high trading sales. Okay, these all characteristics you will quantify them and you will have a quantitative filter. So first you will apply a quantitative filter, ठीक है, and उसके बाद जाके हर एक की वेबसाइट पे देखोगे, because quantitative filter के बाद भी बहुत सारी चीजें छूट जाती हैं, and then you go to every website and prepare an accept reject matrix, okay, and this after that you will prepare your I would say margins. Last one slide, few important tips for TP search. See, आपने एक बार देख लिया ये software, but there are some transactions where we have to run 20 times this search, where it's a fight between sometimes me and my team. Okay, if Harshita is there from my team, she knows how many times I reject it and how many times she has to go again, give it to articles and all it starts. Then sometimes there is a fight between us and client, and a lot of trial and error approach. So, you know, variety of filter, the again FAR is important. जितना आप अपनी कंपनी को समझ सकोगे उतना आप फिल्टरिंग लगा सकोगे. फॉर्मूला शुड बी वेरी वेरी मेड कंसिस्टेंटली. यू कैन राइट ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 2, उसकी जगह ग्रेटर देन लिख दिया तो एवरीथिंग विल गो रॉन्ग. ओके, बी केयरफुल व्हाइल डूइंग बिजनेस. बीडी इज बिजनेस डिस्क्रिप्शन एट एक्सेप्ट रिजेक्ट मैट्रिक्स ओवर गूगल फॉर्म आई एक्सप्लेन यू. ओके, जब आप ये बीडी करते हो तब सबको डॉक्यूमेंट करो. तो अगर आप देखेंगे पीछे में लेके जाऊं आपको, वी हैव डॉक्यूमेंटेड कि कौन कौन सी साइट से हमने लिया है. What site we have used? कल को कोई ये नहीं बोलते this is your own forged data. No, we document the site, we document the company name, we document the business description. Okay, so this is very very important. Safe user set after every step. You may never know from which step the things may change. Okay, suddenly you will say no, manufacturing cost should be 60%, nahi 50%, it should be 75%, whatever way. So save every user set after every step, so you can start from there. This is Provis specific. Save user batch after finalizing. You know, sometimes what happens is that one after 2 years, when the scrutiny comes after 3 years, the transformation officer asks you ki user batch liana whatever you run, okay, and then you apply the user user batch. And you give him on the pen drive and he can run on his whole software. Sara apne aap chal jayega kaun sa kaun sa select kiya tha. So save that user batch after finalizing TP study. It comes handy during the assessment stage. One timer hota hai ki our client itne specific hote hain. So like I was working on a client which was a trading some pneumatic valves aur uska kuch available nahi tha. Hardly two companies from the Provis came and the client was hell bent. No, I cannot accept two companies, you have to get more companies. So we asked him, what are your competitors available in the market? He told us 10 competitors available in the market. Okay, we went to the ROC, we downloaded all the data and we run through all the filters, okay, on that ROC data. Out of that, 4 companies survived. Okay, and then we took that 4 company, 4 plus 2, 6 companies totality, and totality we made the margin. So this additive approach can also be followed, okay, and but it has to go through very very stringent similar criteria what all the other companies have gone through. Okay, so when you don't find any sometimes comparable or you find very less, you can try and the client is asking you to find it more, okay, and we search all the 3 software, hame nahi mila, so then you can obviously go for an additive approach also, but with very very stringent way of doing it. So that is something which could be there you know, you can also see that kahi par abnormal expenses aate hain, so you go have to see ki kahi extraordinary expenses aate hain wo hatana padega. There could be, you know, some companies where there could be abnormal expenses or abnormal profit is there. You have to actually go through each and every company's ROC financials to justify that whatever is there is correct or not, and your such company can be taken or not. There are some companies which have abnormal profit. Okay, so one of the criteria of accept reject can be abnormal profit also. Okay, that also can be rejected, but you have to show that ये तो ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता. Trade में ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता abnormal profit. Okay, so that is something also can be used. So I think this is all from my side regarding how one search is processed. I know you will be having many questions. Okay, but we'll take them once Chaitanya go through his next 20-25 minutes, some advanced concepts. If you like it, and my team is also there on the VC today, if you like the way we dealt with the subject and all through 3 days, please pour in your comments. You can mail it us also and everything. My team would be very happy, and thank you everybody to go through this presentation. And Chaitanya, is now over to you.
Thank you, Naman. Hello. Am I audible to everyone? Hope. Okay.
Yeah.
So, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome for the last session of this wonderful webinar series organized by the Botnext team organizers, Virag and Abhishek. So, thank you, Naman, and thank you, the organizers. And in fact, thanks to all the participants who have were attending and hearing us for past 3 days patiently. So it was a wonderful presentation and exam with wonderful and clear example given by Naman of the search process. I have to present the advanced transfer pricing, and then we will go for one or two illustrations of what we can say comparable search process. So friends, today yesterday we have done the transfer pricing concepts basic. The basic
is at least I can't see the screen. I don't know.
My screen is not visible.
At least I can't see that. I don't know. If Virag and Abhishek can confirm or
sharing screen.
Screen is disconnected.
Show screen. It's not it's disabled, I think.
I don't know.
Virag, Abhishek, it's all coming black over here. I am able to see your screen. I think you have to stop your screen, and then I am able to add up.
Okay, make presenter. I have to make
you
presenter. Okay.
Yeah, I have got the option. Correct.
Okay, perfect. Yeah,
perfect.
You can see. Yeah.
So, I'll continue with this. Today's topic is advanced transfer pricing concepts. So, basic to humne kal dekh liya tha. What is AE, international transaction, specified domestic transactions, and applicability of all the basic transfer pricing concepts and compliances, that is Form 3CED and the documentation part. So now today we are going to move ahead for advanced transfer pricing concepts, which have been introduced recently because of the BEPS action plans introduced by the OECD countries, and along with the various countries across the globe, and India is one of the most aggressive countries to introduce this OECD country. So ek example lete hain. So abhi tak kya ho raha tha, suppose this is a Google, Google was there, and there was this. Just now I have made the example to explain it easily. So kindly forgive me for my handwriting. So suppose Google is there. I think everyone is able to see what I'm trying to explain. Naman.
Yeah, we can see that.
Screen is visible, correct. So we have Google. So it is having an entity in Cayman Island, which is a tax haven. So what is tax haven where we don't have to, where is, there is no tax or low tax, very less tax applicable on the income. And they are mainly for the investment purposes, like Cayman Island. So Google has an entity at in Cayman Island, and in fact there are other entities which has been incorporated into various tax jurisdictions across the globe: Singapore, India, US, Australia, South Africa, Spain, UK, Japan. So what happened was Google, these transfer pricing, basic transfer pricing concepts were not sufficient to counter the base erosion profit shifting, or the shifting of the profit, because everyone tried very well to manage the profitability and shift the remaining profitability to the tax havens or tax havens where there is very low or no tax applicable. Then what happened? Countries, higher tax paying countries across the globe, they came to know, and in fact these multinational enterprises like Google, Apple, they took the benefit of tax arbitrage. Ek jagah tax zyada lag raha tha, ek jagah kam lag raha tha. So aisa tax arbitrage was opportunity have was been created, and they started siphoning of the profit from tax higher tax jurisdictions. Like we can take example of India. Though the majority of economic activities was conducted, everything, customer base, suppose in India is having a wide customer base, everything was done in India, but the as per the economic activity, that proportionate profit was not being kept into Indian jurisdiction, rather that was shifted to tax havens. In our example, Cayman Island. Then India, suppose Indian, US, and all the entities across the globe, they started making certain adjustments or payments, which all these entities across the globe have to pay to the entity incorporated into Cayman Island. So actually the economic activity was done by whole of the global entities across the globe of the same group, international group Google. So they started shifting, like few of the examples can be capital structure of Indian entity. So 100 crore was the capital structure, out of which only 1 crore paid up capital was there, and 99 crore capital was introduced as a loan. So by way of paying interest on such loan, Indian entity of Google was taking benefit of deduction of that interest, and that interest was transferred to entity like Cayman Island. And second example can be royalty payments.
Chaitanya bhai, awaz? Hello? Hello?
The owner or creator of the brand Google, correct? Jo Google brand hai, US entity hold kar. So So that Google brand has been created by US entity, and that brand or intellectual property, which is their logo, all the logo has been legally or documented form mein, it has been transferred to Cayman Island entity. So in this way, they started paying the royalty to Cayman Island entity because it became the legal owner and not the beneficial owner. So it was ultimately going to US only, but this Cayman Island and entity started its building the profitability, or profit was increasing because every entity across the globe of the international group Google, so it was paying royalty to that Cayman Island entity. Suppose there this entity was formed only for the purpose of maintenance activity or management activity, services like this was provided by this Cayman Island entity to Singapore, India, US, Australia, Spain, or across the globe. But this was on papers, this was documented, but actually this functions were provided to all across the globe, say by Japanese entity. So this Japanese entity was given only certain amount, cost plus some percentage of profit, say 5% or 10%, but remaining profit was shifted to Cayman Island entity by way of payment of management charges or management fees by all these entities across the globe. So by this, these were new types of transactions. A new type of transactions they. These were the new types of transactions and innovative ways. Jaise ki bola gaya tha, like yesterday, day before yesterday, we discussed that businesses change drastically or very easily rather than laws. So seeing this, every tax payment or tax haven were under the purview of all the countries or the OECD countries, in fact, which were having higher tax rates compared to those tax havens. So in this scenario, what like we have seen unity strength. So all the countries across the globe came together along with OECD countries, and they form an agreement and BEPS action plan. They come with the BEPS action plans. They have agreed with the BEPS action plans. There are 15 action plans, and one of the action plan was action plan 13. And through that, this action plan, ye normal TP documentation ke saath, they have prescribed two more documentation, that is country by country reporting and master file documentation. So these have been incorporated into Indian Income Tax Act and effective wide section 92D and section 286. So they came together, they showed their strength by uniting and incorporating, drafting and incorporating all the measures of BAPS action plan, and action plan 13 was one of those action plan jisko implement karne se, matlab, when it was implemented, it made the world as one tax jurisdiction. So we will discuss this, how it is going to make the world as one tax jurisdiction, kyunki multinationals across the globe have to comply with these documentation, compliances, master file documentation, country by country reporting, and they have to comply with these documentation like they as a one tag, making all the countries who have approved this and implemented into their income tax or domestic tax laws all the action plan 13 compliances, and we will discuss this, how this will be happening over the years between the countries across the globe. They will be say sharing these master file and country by country reporting with the countries where the MNCs have presence. some of the information or documentation would be shared automatically, and some would be shared on request basis, and there would be some audits. So this would be at certain point of time, it might be started, I think, from this year or next year. So we are just sticking to the basics of applicability of master file documentation and country by country reporting. Now,
one remark I wanted to make.
Yeah.
So basically, you know, the BEPS action plan came, and more specifically, let's say if we take it to transfer pricing, you know, so you know, let's assume there are let's say five houses. Okay, and or rather I would say five people, and there is one thief. Okay, and this one thief used to go to each and every one houses, not thief exactly, or a liar person, I would say, ekdam jhoota aadmi tha koi, aur wo har jagah jaake bolta tha ki I am a right person, par wo har jagah se chori kar leta tha. You know, and these five people, these house people, never used to communicate with each other. Ki, you know, this person has taken from me also. This person has taken, you know, loan from me also. This person has taken loan money from me also. Okay, and so they never used to communicate with each other, and he used to take loan from one person, pay to another, or maybe, you know, used to run away. So the corporates used to run it away in such a manner that they never used to pay tax anywhere. So now these countries come together, and now the data needs to be presented to these five home all together, you know, in a together manner. So one data needs to be presented like in CBCR or master file in one manner. Okay, these will be to identify ki this person is lying to everyone. So that's the whole premise of BEPS or CBCR or master file. Okay, you please go ahead.
Yes, correctly said, Naman bhai. So for detecting that thief, this compliance was brought into the tax laws, in fact tax law, domestic tax laws of the countries which agree to the BEPS action plan 13, and this BEPS action plan have in fact highlights the concept of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which we can say in Sanskrit, that it has brought a whole of the country together, whole of the globe together, all the countries across the globe together. I'm unable to, so this is one of the compliance or provisions which is very close to my heart, because there are various websites on which these have been presented. All you can see on the slide where an article was written by me and one of my colleague, Advocate Amay Khare. So these were published, like we were tracking this compliance since 6 months. I was in fact very concerned and about various forms applicable, both, and the name of the forms was very confusing. And in fact, it was that much confusing that they were they help because of them some people might forget this alphabets of English, because you will come to know how. Then this is what is transfer pricing. So this is, we have already learned. I just go to the concepts. So these are the various tax MNCs who are playing with the tax haven tax across the globe. And once this Apple reported 0.006% of corporate tax rate across the globe. So now we come to BEPS Action Plan 13. So what is BEPS Action Plan 13? Ek to global TP compliance hai, MNCs have to comply globally and give all the strategic business decisions or strategic decisions or implementation carried on by the MNCs, and along with that the financial information, which we will see in later slides. BEPS Action Plan 13 is one of the steps, as I have told, that making world as one tax jurisdiction and this was in fact the same better transparency. So what are the three objectives were there for BEPS section plan 13? That for the objective first is the TP risk assessment, ensure taxpayers give appropriate consideration to setting prices. So if in one tax jurisdiction, say group entity is having higher profit, but the industry-wide profit was low in tax in that tax jurisdiction. So the balance of the profit was shifted to other jurisdiction where in tax havens. So to curb this, but in fact it should have been morally into that tax haven jahan pe isne actual activity ki hai, ki jahan pe is group ne apne enterprises ke through actual activity ki hai, say manufacturing, say trading, aur us activity ke basis pe wahan ka profit set hona padega. And third is tax authorities would initiate audits of these documentation across the globe of the MNCs. So now I have already told that three-tiered standardized structure was there in the master file documentation, local file, and country by country reporting. So these are the forms: master file documentation, which is the form 3CEAA under Indian Income Tax. Local file is normal transfer pricing study report, the documentation which we have just now seen and understood yesterday. Country by country reporting is allocation of the MNE's income. These MNE's multinational enterprises, I am telling this is enterprise and not the corporates. So enterprise is, as explained, that it is a wider term than a company. It includes firms and proprietorship firm, partnership firm, LLP, trust, AOP, BOI, every sort of enterprise. A permanent establishment can be an enterprise because of the definition of enterprise under section 92F. So any unit carrying on the business would be considered as enterprise of that group and would be come under the purview of this compliance. So this country by country reporting is more of the factual or actual data and information based on financial statements, rather master file documentation is based on strategic management done by the multinational group across the globe. So what are the provisions under the act for master file documentation? The provisions under the act, section 92D, subsection 1, clause 2, refers read with rule 10DA, which casts the responsibility of preparation and maintenance of the master file documentation on the constituent entity. We will discuss this definitions later. Constituent entity, IG, is international group. And 92D4, subsection 4, read with rule 10DA, covers the master file documentation filing. First is the preparation and maintenance. Second is filing of the documentation as prescribed. Next is the penalty, which we will discuss later. And for country by country reporting, also there are two provisions, section 286 and section 271 GB, which is of penalty. 286 has to be read with 10 DB. All these documents have to be filed electronically with joint commissioner as may be designated by Director General of Income Tax Risk Assessment, and this is all together electronically, so we don't have to consider that the physical submission of this is for the purpose of knowledge. Now these are the relevant definitions. Hum agar master file documentation, country by country reporting, which are very heavy words, these definitions would in fact ease out the applicability of these documentation. Jo hamara documentation hai usko how to apply, when to apply, and on whom to apply. So we are going to discuss the definitions, and then on the basis of this definition we will be able to understand those concepts the alternate reporting entity. What is alternate reporting entity? Suppose in our example in this, this US company is the head office, ultimate parent entity of whole Google in group. So normally across the globe, this entity is required to comply with the country by country reporting. And in fact, if this, suppose ye US entity bolti hai ki I am not in position, I am not having time to prepare this documentation, I want to appoint Australian entity as the alternate reporting entity. That is, ये पूरे ग्रुप के बिहाफ पे कंट्री बाय कंट्री रिपोर्टिंग जो डॉक्यूमेंटेशन है, ये पूरे ग्रुप के बिहाफ पे एक पेरेंट एंटिटी कंप्लाई करती है, सबमिट करती है उसके टैक्स ज्यूरिसडिक्शन में, और एल्स द इट डेजिग्नेट अदर एंटिटी ऑफ दैट ग्रुप टू कंप्लाई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ होल ऑफ दैट ग्रुप. तो ये अल्टरनेट रिपोर्टिंग एंटिटी हो गई हमारी ऑस्ट्रेलियन एंटिटी. सो it gives this responsibility of filing CVCR to Australia on behalf of whole of the Google Incorporation international group. So Australia jo hai would considered as alternate reporting entity in our example, correct? Now enterprise or entity, so we have discussed that this is a broader concept, and I'll move ahead. Relevant definitions includes may important definition of group. So this we can see, group is a parent entity and all the entities in respect of which, due to ownership or control, a consolidated financial statement for financial reporting purposes required to be prepared under any law. Or ye ek hypothetical situation bhi inhone le liya that would have been required to prepare consolidated financial statements. एक ग्रुप वो है, मतलब ग्रुप को ऐसा डिफाइन किया है कि द कंसोलिडेटेड फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट्स अल्टीमेटली. हेलो सो आई कंटिन्यू. ग्रुप डेफिनेशन ऑफ ग्रुप, द ग्रुप वुड बी कंसिडर्ड एज the all the entities into a consolidated financial reporting jin entities ki kisi financial statements mein hoti hai, like in our this US is the ultimate parent entity and all the entities are across the globe would be considered as consolidated financial group entities of those group, and holistically the financial statements of all the entities in are consolidated into the financial statements of US. So ise group bolenge. Then international group. International group is group where there more than two enterprises or equal to two enterprises are resident of different countries. So is case mein ek holding subsidiary hai, holding into India, subsidiary into US. So in this case holding is India is one entity, US is India and one country, US is second country, and if it says enterprises resident of different countries, so in this case it is an international group. But dono entity is suppose India mein hi hai, so consolidation to ho raha hai, group to hai, but it's not into different countries, so in that case it would not be international group. Next is constituent entity. So this constituent entity we have to understand it very well. Ab jaise consolidation ho raha hai, jis entities ka in financial statements mein consolidation ho raha hai. In our example, US is the ultimate parent entity jiske consolidated financial statement ban rahe hain, and into that all of the entities across the globe, their financials have been added or incorporated and consolidated in short. So all those entities जिन जिन का उन फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट में कंसोलिडेशन हो रहा है, इंक्लूडिंग द अल्टीमेट पैरेंट एंटिटी, ऑल दोज एंटिटीज वुड बी इंडिविजुअली called as constituent entity. An entity would include permanent establishment also, a branch also, and the step down subsidiaries also, in case they are consolidated into that ultimate parent entity's financial statements. Now, parent entity is same ultimate parent entity we are talking about, is that entity whose financial statements are not consolidated into any other entity's financial statements, but it consolidates financial statements of all the other entities. So I would want to show this one. So this is an example. BCCI Incorporation US is having 100% holding into Gavaskar, German company, Sachin Limited, Indian company, and Dhoni Private Limited, Singapore entity. So now this Sachin is having investment as a subsidiary as Sehwag LLP India, and Sachin is having 20% stake in Mitali Private Limited India, and further Dhoni Private Limited is having a PE in India. This Singapore entity is having PE in India, and this last Mitali Private Limited is having a PE in South Africa. So now, if we go by this, suppose BCCI Incorporation USA is consolidating its financial statements. So in this case, consolidation would be done of Sehwag into Sachin, but as per Indian accounting standard norms, this Mitali Private Limited would not be considered as for consolidation purpose into Sachin. And but Sachin would be consolidated into BCCI, Gavaskar German company would be consolidated into BCCI, and Dhoni Private Limited Singapore would be consolidated into BCCI in US, or including this Virat PE, which is a PE in India. So this would also be consolidated. So in this, the parent entity would be BCCI Incorporation USA, correct? Because it is not, its financial statements are not being incorporated into any other corporate entity or any other entity. So this, and suppose if this, in this US entity, one entity comes, say a Dubai entity. Dubai entity says that Dubai entity is having a 35% stake into US entity. As per laws of Dubai entity, the consolidation of US entity would be done into the Dubai entity. So now ultimate parent entity would become Dubai entity in this case. So this, if this could be there a scenario, then Dubai entity would be the parent entity of this whole group. But if this is not the scenario, the USA entity would be a group parent entity. Now I just wanted to engage with all the participants. From Indian perspective, how many constituent entities are there? Indian constituent entities are there in this structure? ये वाले structure में, BCCI वाले example में, कौन सी India की constituent entities मानी जाएगी? So as per the definition, जो भी एक enterprise या entity है उस group का, उसको और वो consolidate हो रहा है, तो इस case में Indian entities are Sehwag LLP India, Sachin Limited India, and Virat Sales PE in India, PE of Dhoni Private Limited. All these entities would be considered as constituent entities in India, and three is the correct one. Suppose amendment is there in accounting standards of India, and Sachin Limited have to consolidate Mithali Private Limited into its financial statements, then there would be 5 constituent entities in India. So because Mithali would be have to consolidate Smriti Enterprises, Smriti Enterprises is South African entity. So 4 of there, Sachin, Sarang, Mithali and Virat. Now accounting year ki definition samajhna bahut important hai, because hame Indian perspective se accounting year is the previous year. If the parent entity is India, Indian entity, तो उस केस में प्रीवियस ईयर जो है उसे ही अकाउंटिंग ईयर डिफाइन किया गया है. बट इन एनी अदर केस द पेरेंट एंटिटी इज रिसाइडिंग और रेसिडेंट ऑफ दैट कंट्री, वहां पे जो अकाउंटिंग पीरियड दैट इज फॉलोइंग दैट वुड बी कंसिडर्ड एज अकाउंटिंग ईयर. सो दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट टू लर्न ड्यू फॉर द एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑफ वेरियस फॉर्म्स in master file and country by country reporting. So I am not going into these is the basic applicability of form 3CAA part A. Any constituent entity of an international group in India have to file this form 3CAA part A. So constituent entity in India are only two in this example, Sachin Limited and Sehwag Limited LLP India. Because this Virat Sales PE is a non-resident. PE is non-resident, and so it is not required to file this 3CAA Part A. Now 3CAA Part B. These conditions which we have understood yesterday, I'll just explain in brief that Part B is applicable when there is a consolidated group revenue of more than 500 crore during that accounting year. So we have seen the definition of accounting year. So 500 crore plus international transaction during accounting year is more than 50 crores. So when both of these conditions satisfied, then Part B is applicable. Or if 500 crore turnover condition is satisfied of consolidated group revenue plus international transaction in respect of intangible property, purchase, sale, lease and use of intangible property is more than 10 crores. So in that case, Part B would be applicable. These are the two conditions when the Part B would be applicable. And now there is a form 3CEAB. Ye paanch form hai, master file ke do form hai, 3CEAA and compliance ke liye ek aur form hai 3CEAB, but 3CEAB is just the entity, designated entity. Like abhi yahan pe hamare example mein there are two Indian entities, correct? Resident in India, Sachin Limited, Sehwag Limited, jinka consolidation ho raha hai DCCI Incorporation USA. So अब मास्टर फाइल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन 3CAA दोनों को फाइल करना है कि एक ही को करना है, इफ ये कंफ्यूजन हो जाएगा. तो फॉर एंड दिस वुड बी एन एडिशनल बर्डन ऑन बोथ द एंटिटीज, इफ बोथ द एंटिटीज ऑन द ग्रुप, इनफैक्ट इफ बोथ द एंटिटीज आर रिक्वायर्ड टू फाइल विद द कंप्लाई विद दिस डॉक्यूमेंटेशन. तो 3CEAB इज दैट इंटीमेशन विच इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय वन ऑफ द ग्रुप एंटिटी इन इंडिया ऑफ द ग्रुप दैट आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ होल ग्रुप I am complying with the master file documentation of this international group. So for these master file documentation, the rate of exchange for calculating the turnover international transaction limits. So in case they are into the foreign currency, they have to be converted into Indian currency at the rate TT buying rate of currency on last day of that accounting year. And this is a simple flowchart which can be seen for applicability of form 3CAA Part A, Part B and 3CEAB, which we have understood now. Now, master file documentation, I am just going through the categories of information we have to comply with. So there are five types of categories of which we have to file with the authorities in India and across the globe. In fact, it is acceptable across the globe. So these are organizational structure wise compliances or information, business description, intangibles related information, financial activities related information, consolidated financial statement, and tax position, which is others. So these have to be these are the categories of information which have to be filed with the income tax department in form 3CEAA part B. Specifically, part A is just one pager form. We have to just inform them number of entities of the number of constituted entities in India of the group by one of the entities, and part B contains all these information which are strategic information. And this master file documentation has to be maintained for 8 years. It has been prescribed under Rule 10DA. Master file organizational structure is normally like all and list of entities with addresses and chart, legal status and ownership structure. Then business description information are nature of business, drivers of profits of the business of group globally, five largest products or services of consolidated group revenue, and along with more than 5% in goods or services which are forming part of the global revenue, consolidated revenue. Then important service arrangements, the capability between the companies of the group or entities of the group, capabilities of service providers. Like we have seen one of the entity, say suppose in this example, Sachin Limited is providing only management charges or management consultancy in relation to HR and recruitment plus IT to whole of the group globally. So that would Sachin would become the main service provider in this example, one of the service provider entity. And what are the arrangements? Then TP policies for allocating service costs. So say Sachin follows cost plus 10%, it charges to whole of the group entities. So these policy have to be complied, have to be mentioned into this form. Major geographical markets, and then FAR analysis of those constituent entities which contribute more than 10%. More than or equal to 10% of revenue or assets or profits of such group. So this analysis have to be done first, and then their FAR analysis have to be provided. Basic business structuring transactions have to be provided. Now intangible related, like I have given example in our Google one, that royalty payment was done by all the entities of Google group into the Cayman Island entity for holding intellectual property, say brand or logo. So in that case, development or ownership and exploitation, which company is developing that property, intellectual property, which is owning that property on paper as a legal owner, and exploitation, which is using that property, all the companies which are using that property, then engage all the entities engaged in the development of IPR that have to be mentioned separately, and names and addresses of the entities who are legal owners of intellectual property, and the agreements and R&D and IP policies of the intellectual property and research and development related policies of the group. Then important transfers of interest in IP and the financial activities. The financial activities are arrangements like we have understood the 100 crore example, that 1 crore was the cash share capital and 99 crore was the loan provided by foreign entity to Indian entity, Cayman Island entity to Indian entity, and that interest deduction was given was taken into by the computation of income by Indian entity. So this was there. So in understanding that situation, financing arrangements and top 10 lenders of the group, and then operation where from where the financial service providing entities performing its operation, and where from where it's performing in the effective management, the POEM concept will come into play over here, and TP policies of international group in relation to financing arrangements. And this is the others information which we have to comply or into comply with form 3CAA and furnish to the department copy of the financial consolidated financial statements of the group. Ab ye to hame lagega ki consolidated financial statements jo hai what all names of the names or parties are being consolidated into that group. So iska base documentation would be consolidated financial statement only. So we have to file that copy with into that along with the master file documentation applicability and existing unilateral advance pricing agreements, any APAs entered with any government with across the globe by that international group, or other tax rulings applicable to that international group. So this was the basics or information to be provided in master file documentation part B of form 3CAA. Now there are three other forms, and this is the country by country reporting template, the third documentation which has to be which is applicable only on the companies having consolidated group revenue, or groups in fact consolidated group revenue for the financial year ending in previous year, ending previous year. In fact, जो करंट फाइनेंशियल ईयर है उसके पहले वाला जो फाइनेंशियल ईयर है, वी हैव टू सी दैट फाइनेंशियल ईयर एंड द ग्लोबल रेवेन्यू ऑफ दैट फाइनेंशियल ईयर शुड बी मोर देन रुपीज 5,500 करोड़. सो ओनली इन दोज केसेस दिस वुड बी एप्लीकेबल. आई विल जस्ट गो थ्रू नॉर्मली. दिस इज द फ्लो चार्ट ऑफ. हाँ,
what I'm saying is that this CBCR will not be much of a help to, you know, all of us, because this,
so I'm just keeping that applicability. I'm just showing this chart is self explanatory of for applicability of various forms, and we can easily understand this. So CBCR is also having three parts: part A, part B, part C. And part A is mainly the financial information and few of the other information, and part B is like FAR analysis in short, which entity is doing research and development, which entity is holding managing intellectual property and all. This is an FAR analysis of that, the accounting period of which this CBCR is part. And this is part C, any other information from our side we have to provide, or anything prescribed by the entities across the countries or governments across the globe. So these are the timelines. Basically, I will focus the timelines of master file documentation. 3CAA have to be filed by due date of filing of return, that is for assessment year 2021. It will be 38 November only, and not 31st October, which that is only for 3CEB. 31st November is, sorry, 38th November would be for 3CEAA, part A, part B, both. But for 3CEAB, have to be filed 30 days prior to due date of filing 3CEAA. So that is 31st October. So 3CEAB have to be filed in advance or before filing, that to 30 days prior to that. So for master file documentation, fail to furnish even the part A, that is form 3CAA part A, then also the straight away there is 5 lakh penalty. This such type of penalty is nowhere in the Income Tax Act, or very rare in the Income Tax Act for such high penalties. And so this is very important for the clients or assessees to file in India when the applicability of master file documentation is there. So the remaining penalties are relating to basically CBCR reporting, and that I am skipping for now, but these are also very high penalties applicable to in case of non-compliance or non-filing of the documentation of CBCR. So now we have with this example, we have, I think, understood the concept of applicability of this master file documentation and CBCR. Now, next, I'll just go through in brief for two of the sections, which are also advanced transfer pricing concepts, 92 CE and 94 B. 92 CE deals with excess money. Jab hamara, we have a TP assessment, and in that, we have an adjustment of transfer pricing. It is called a primary adjustment, and that is the excess amount would be called as excess money, and would be, it is a deemed debt to associate enterprise that humne zyada money diya hua hai, and notional interest is charged on that in excess money. And 94B pertains to excess interest paid to an AE. If we have paid excess amount of interest, and then actual debt from it is based on actual debt or actual transaction, and actual interest expense is paid, which might be more than the interest expense limitation which is prescribed under this 94B. So this was introduced section 92C in Finance Act 2017, and why the OECD TP guidelines recommended for a secondary adjustment. And there were three types of secondary adjustment, and India has opted that secondary adjustment to treat as loan instead of constructive dividend or constructive equity contribution. So what was the purpose? The purpose was the cash profit alignment with transfer pricing. So hamara jo actual profit hai aur transfer pricing adjustment hai, तो वो दोनों मैच करने के लिए ये सेकेंडरी एडजस्टमेंट लाया गया था कि से 100 रुपीज का एडिशन किया है तो आवर प्रॉफिट हैज गॉन डाउन बाय 100 रुपीज, सो वी विल ब्रॉट द प्रॉफिट फ्रॉम एसोसिएट एंटरप्राइज विच वी हैव एंटर्ड इनटू इंटरनेशनल ट्रांजेक्शन, और फिर वो एक्चुअली जो हमारा प्रॉफिट होना चाहिए था वही हमारा एक्चुअल में प्रॉफिट हुआ एज पर ट्रांसफर प्राइसिंग एडजस्टमेंट. So the foreign exchange, we have to get back the foreign exchange, and the notional interest concept was introduced to curb this secondary adjustment criteria. So I think how much time we have left? 20 or
25
minutes. 30 minutes, correct. So what I'll do is, these are in depth slides. So in this we'll just go through when is the applicability of secondary adjustment. So secondary adjustment would be done only when there is a primary adjustment to transfer pricing in five of these conditions. Ki humne suo moto basis pe apply kiya hai secondary adjustment, addition kar diya in our transfer pricing. Here we have less margin, so we added up margins and form 3C bhi humne file kar diya on that basis. So secondary adjustment and primary, normally this is not done by all the assessees. It's not a practice, in fact, but in some times as an auditor we have to follow or we have to apply our professional judgment, and accordingly we might have to go into the addition of transfer pricing. And then when the addition is made by AO, third is when the transfer pricing adjustment is done due to determination of income as per advanced pricing agreement entered with the Indian government. Then for primary adjustment made as per safe harbor rules if we have applied on the Indian entity of that group. And fifth is the arising due to mutual agreement procedure entered into by that group with the government of India. So these are the conditions when the secondary adjustment have to be done. That is the adjustment to be done into the books of account of the entity in whose addition of transfer pricing is done. So this is secondary adjustment. Primary adjustment is addition of transfer pricing. Secondary adjustment is adjustment into the books of account of that primary adjustment. So this is the basic concept of secondary adjustment. So now this excess money has to be added back and to be considered as loan provided to the associate enterprise with whom we have done the international transaction. And exception to this amount is less than 1 crore, then this is not applicable, or this transaction is done in assessment year 16-17 or earlier assessment year, then this is not applicable. Now, Indian income tax, in case the AAE is not able to pay this excess interest or excess amount, then Indian entity has been given an option to pay this amount, excess amount, at the tax at 18% on such money, and it would be considered that there would be no adjustment required of into the books that has already been done and treated as final payment of tax liability, and then no deduction from this, also no deduction would be available from this excess money. So notional interest is been prescribed, how to calculate, and time limits have been prescribed under Rule 10CB. These are various situations of calculating the interest, when the timing, or since what date the 90 days of that secondary adjustment has to be done within 90 days of the primary adjustment. So if the, this is 90 days, we have to calculate in this manner, like for an example, due date of filing of return is the one date when assessee makes suo motu adjustment. So within 90 days of 38 November, say to 2020, assessee have to make the adjustment. So all will be applicable. This is one of the illustration. Now, I'll come to rate of interest. In case international transaction is done in INR, then rate of interest would be 1 year marginal cost of fund lending rate of SBI as on April 1 of that previous year. That is for 17-18 previous year, it was 8% plus 325 basis points. And if the international transaction is into foreign currency, then we have to take interest rate at on the basis of LIBOR, 6 month LIBOR as on 38 September of that previous year plus 300 basis points.
Chaitanya, voice is not coming. Hello. Hello. Chaitanya. So sorry, Chaitanya, voice is not coming. Is my voice audible? Can anybody reply on the chat if my voice is audible? Okay, perfect. So if as and when he comes, basically he wants to explain this secondary adjustment. The whole concept of secondary adjustment is such that ठीक है आपने ट्रांसफर प्राइसिंग पे लेट से यू हैव सोल्ड योर असेसिंग एंटरप्राइज टू 10 रुपीज ओके और आपको वो 12 रुपए का करना चाहिए था ओके सो अभी तक से 2 साल पहले तक यू नो इट वॉज जस्ट दैट दैट 2 रुपीज वॉज टू बी एडेड ओके नाउ द टैक्स टैक्स ऑफिसर सेइंग दैट इफ यू हैड एक्चुअली सोल्ड दैट एट 12 रुपीज ओके यू वुड हैव गॉट दैट 2 रुपीज एंड दैट 2 रुपीज ऑल्सो यू हैव रियलाइज इन टाइम एंड देयरफॉर वुड हैव मेक यूज ऑफ दैट मनी ओके एंड इफ यू हैव मेक यूज ऑफ दैट मनी योर प्रॉफिट वुड हैव बीन हायर तो वो 2 रुपए पे तो टैक्स दे ही दो ओके एडिशनल बट बिकॉज दैट 2 रुपीज हैज नॉट कम नाउ इधर यू ब्रिंग इट दैट इन 90 डेज ओके एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम व्हेन यू डूइंग अ सो मोटो एंड इफ यू डोंट ब्रिंग इट ओके देन पे इंटरेस्ट ऑन दैट ऑल्सो सो द करंट स्लाइड विच इज देयर इज दैट यू नो यू पे इंटरेस्ट ऑन एमसीएलआर प्लस दिस मेनी बेसिस पॉइंट So that's the whole concept of secondary adjustment. कि primary तो okay, आपको ज्यादा पैसा लाना चाहिए था इंडिया में आप नहीं लेकर आए वेरी गुड यू नो यू जस्ट एड ओके बट क्योंकि वो पैसा अगर आप लेकर आते इफ यू वुड हैव बॉट दैट मनी यू हैव वुड हैव बेसिकली यूटिलाइज दैट मनी एंड अर्न मोर प्रॉफिट एंड देयरफॉर दैट एडिशनल एडजस्टमेंट ऑल्सो नीड्स टू बी देयर दैट इज सेकेंडरी एडजस्टमेंट बेसिकली ओके So that is the secondary adjustment. There are many other concepts. This slide obviously I cannot move, but if you concentrate, I know it's been you know 4 days, last 15-20 minutes. Please just you know be with me for last 15-20 minutes, and I'll explain you more concepts. Something you know someone asked about safe harbor. No, you know you all of us would realize that this is a so much tedious process. इतना सारा यू नो परम्यूटेशन कॉम्बिनेशन बना के यू फाइंड आउट सिमिलर कंपनीज यू फाइंड आउट देयर प्रॉफिट परसेंटेज एंड यू सडनली रियलाइज ओह दिस परसेंटेज इज नॉट देयर दिस इज नॉट एट एज पर आर्म्स लेंथ एंड इट्स कॉजेस सो मच आई वुड से डिसएग्रीमेंट बिटवीन द ट्रांसफर प्राइसिंग ऑफिसर एंड इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर ओके टू सॉल्व दैट पर्पस द इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर केम आउट विद सर्टेन गाइडलाइंस दैट दीज आर द सेफ हार्बर You will be safe if you follow this percentage. So, like software, they gave a safe harbor percentage of 17%. Okay, कि अगर आपकी software company 17% कमाती है, okay, no need for anything. You are into safe harbor zone. You are fine. It doesn't matter. Okay, and you just file your 3CB and everything and be happy. That is not an issue. Okay, so there are certain categories where safe harbor. But those are typically very, very high rates. A typical software company these days earn 10, 12%, 13%. 17 is very high. So until unless your company is happy paying that much tax, very good, go into safe harbor. Okay, no need to maintain so much documentation. Just file 3CV, be happy. Okay, but if your company is not just like that, okay, then obviously, you know, better to follow. So there are very few cases where people go into safe harbor. That is my personal experience. Okay. There is one somebody saying on chat that secondary adjustment is as good as opportunity cost. Yes, secondary adjustment is very well. You have very well defined it. Secondary adjustment is as good as opportunity cost. Okay. Now there is a concept called APA and MAP. Okay. So APA is advance pricing agreement. Again, you know, people, there are bigger companies. You can't change your pricing every time. Just see what is the arm's length and everything. So what happens is they go to the income tax office, the transfer pricing commissioners, and there is a provision of advance pricing agreement. So they give the whole study. They give the FAR analysis. They give this is the profitability, which is there generally. And for each and every transaction, they decide the price or the profitability or the range in advance. This is in advance and it is decided for next 5 years. Okay. So when it is decided for next 5 years, again, they do not need to maintain anything. You know, they just need to be sure that FAR is same. Aisa nahi suddenly you said you are very low risk taking and you get a margin of 10% and suddenly all the risk is loaded to your own company. So therefore your percentage would be different and then the APA is not. So like an advance ruling, yes, Akshay. So it is like an advance ruling and this is like for next 5 years, you are fine. You just have to report that your fire and everything is exactly like this thing has been same. Okay, so that is an advance ruling. So advance ruling is a unilateral thing. Okay, advance ruling is a unilateral. The assessee comes and assessee comes sit with the transfer pricing officer of one country. Okay, but mutual agreement process MAP. Okay, now what is MAP? Sometimes what happens is, see, understand, a transfer pricing is the double edged sword. Okay, let's say I satisfy Indian tax authorities that I am paying very good tax, high tax in India. Okay, the US authority will say you are paying high tax in India. Okay, if you are paying high tax in India, okay, then you are paying less tax in US. This is US has problem. So you cannot satisfy two people at the same time. Okay, so it's the classic war between Saas and Bahu. Okay, दोनों को संभालना मुश्किल है एक साथ. So the point is that when you can't make both of them happy, you need to bring them on the same plate and introduce mutual agreement process. Okay, MAP. आप दोनों बैठ जाओ, सास एंड बहू, and be happy. Okay, and talk to your terms and conditions. So both country, income tax officers sit and decide on a mutual agreement process that this will be this percentage, over here it will be this percentage, and then it is decided, and that is a MAP for you. So I have covered safe harbor. Sorry, I'm not going into the nitty-gritties and the tax rates and everything. Okay, I'm just sharing the concepts. I hope that is fine. Okay, then map we have discussed, safe harbor we have discussed. Then there is a concept of, lot of many people, equalization levy, Jyoti is asking. So I just give you, we are waiting for Chaitanya to come. So I'll just give you, equalization, an idea about equalization levy. See, what happened was, there were very cases. Now, this is one of the instances when I'm citing case. Ek was famous judgment as a right florist ka. Okay, and there were cases for Google also, where they said that this online advertisement, everything is not taxable in India because this is a business service. There is no technical service, there is no royalty, and this online service and all online advertisement, because there is no permanent establishment in India, it is not taxable in India. So in the BEPS concept, okay, there is a unilateral concept that you levy equalization levy because you cannot tax it in a normal circumstances. So Indian government came out with equalization levy and said, okay, it is not taxable in Income Tax Act, fine. Whatever online activities is going in India, I will levy equalization levy of 6% to you. Okay, this is outside the ambit of Income Tax Act. It is in the Finance Act. Okay, like service tax was there for Finance Act 1994. This is a section in the Finance Act. And when anybody, any Indian pays, any enterprises pays for online services, online advertisement, the equalization levy will be deducted. Okay, so if you're paying 100 amount to Google, 6 will be deducted and 94 will be paid to Google. Okay, and then, this, so that it's a unilateral approach, they might not get, credit also. It depends on their tax system. They might not get credit also for doing it. So this is one of the thing, equalization levy. This is a unilateral approach, and many countries, France has done this already, that doing 3%. Okay, India has a 6%. Okay, which is there. So this is on equalization levy. Now I will go into place of effective management, POEM concept, which is a very, very important concept. Okay, and this might come in handy to you also, depending on the size of the transaction. The threshold limit is little higher, but still. Okay, so place of effective management, again I'm just going into the concept and I hope this is fine, because we don't have that liberty of time as of now to explain each and every concept. So I will rather take concept and then you can read from yourself. Okay, so place of effective management. What is place of effective management? एक इंडिया के अंदर लेट से दिस पर्सन इज सिटिंग and he is selling goods on Amazon USA. Okay, now Amazon USA will not allow an Indian company to Indian person to do that. Okay, now what will happen? He will float a company in US and he will just do buy and sell, have one person over there who will manage his stock and buy and sell on Amazon. Now if you see, all the work is been done in India. The place of effective management is in India. Earlier there was a residentship in section 6, there was a concept that the control and management should be wholly situated in India. Matlab agar ek bhi board meeting bahar ho jati thi, okay, then the place of effective management would be outside India. Log aise hi karte the, ek US ka chakkar maar aate the aur ek board meeting bahar ho gayi, place of effect, the residentship was in of that US company was outside India. But now this place of effective management concept came in, where it says that if after crossing certain threshold, okay, if the country, the company is managed and controlled by India, and they have given very detailed circular, I think in some 2018, I don't remember the circular number or something, but the circular came and they said that if that is India, it will be considered as an Indian resident company, and once it is considered as an Indian resident company, all Indian taxation laws, TDS, tax audit, everything will be applicable in India. Okay, so if you have any such company, or let's say, even I will tell you, if a subsidiary of a foreign company, if a subsidiary of Indian company is there foreign outside, and all the things are done in India, accounts bhi yahi bante hain, sab kuch yahi hota hai, wo khali bana rakhi hai just for one selling purpose, okay, then that company will be constituted at place of effective management in India, obviously subject to the rules and regulation. So that is about place of effective management. Okay, then concept of GAR. Okay, Manthan has asked that concept of GAR. So GAR is a process, general anti avoidance rule. Okay, general anti avoidance rule. So there is a specific anti avoidance rules and there are general anti avoidance rule. Okay, so kya hoga, general anti avoidance rule, specific anti avoidance rules bahut sare India abhi hain. Section 56 is a specific anti avoidance rule. You have a immovable property transaction, agar aapne uski DLC value se kam kiya, that's a specific anti avoidance rule. 48(2)(b), if payment to relative is made and jo is higher payment to made is made to relative, then this is a specific anti avoidance rule. Section 92 is a specific, this transfer pricing is a specific anti avoidance rule. Okay, so this is an anti avoidance rule. Now you cannot emphasize all the condition, you cannot emphasize ki businessman kya kya game khel sakte hain. Okay, so what they did is come as a general anti avoidance rule. So the whole idea is that any scheme you make, any, you know, you're coming from one country to another country to something, any scheme you are making, and that scheme, the one of the main purpose of that scheme is to take the benefit, tax benefit. Okay, you just floated a Mauritius company to take the tax benefit. Okay, that would come into general anti avoidance agreement, and this scheme will be disregarded. This scheme will be disregarded, will be considered as an impermissible avoidance, impermissible transaction. Okay, some word is there, I am forgetting it right now, impermissible something that, and you will have to see it like ki wo entity kabhi thi nahi bich ke andar, and you have to tax it accordingly. So that is general anti avoidance rule. In next 2 to 3 years to come, you will see a lot of litigation on a general anti avoidance. It has given immense power, amazing power, more than the power which they should have to the companies. Okay, it has given to the assessing officer, sorry, to the assessing officer. Okay, how to find out, yeah, thank you, Riddhi, impermissible avoidance agreement. Okay, how to find out cup of any transaction to software? No, software does not provide you a cup transaction for a cup. Software are for only profit transactions and everything. For cup, you either need, you have to have your own transaction, or you can go through like a मंडी कॉपी, मंडी भाव कॉपी, और लेट से बीएससी एनएससी अगर शेयर का ट्रांजेक्शन है तो देर इज सम ट्रांजेक्शन विच इज अवेलेबल दैट कैन बी यू नो डन थ्रू दैट. ओके, so I cannot go up and see if some queries are not answered. So you know, please pardon me, and you can write a query again. I'll try to take it up. Okay. Seems Chaitanya has still not you know be there. So you know, extremely sorry from his side. I'll continue. Okay. Yes. So Naman has written this query 2-3 times. I had earlier seen it. Sorry, Naman, to keep you so waiting. Difference between taxation of a foreign company having POEM in India and foreign company having PE in India. Okay. How to put it? First understand the concept. Foreign company having, see, PE is an inward concept. POEM is an outward concept. ओके, तो अगर कोई फॉरेन एंटिटी, फॉरेन कंपनी इंडिया के अंदर है और वो यहाँ पे ऐसी एक्टिविटी कर रही है जिससे बिजनेस कनेक्शन या परमानेंसी इन देयर डीलिंग हो रहा है, एंड दे आर देयर एंड दे आर डूइंग एक्टिविटीज ऑफ टेकिंग नेगोशिएशन एंड यू नो फाइनलाइजिंग द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एंड ऑल दोस विच इज परमानेंट, देयर वुड बी अ बिजनेस कनेक्शन एंड देयर वुड बी अ परमानेंट एस्टैब्लिशमेंट. दिस विल बी ट्रीटेड एज अ फॉरेन कंपनी इन इंडिया. And they would be taxed, let's say, at a 40% rate or whatever the foreign company is taxed on. So it's an inward concept. India ke andar aa rahe ho. Okay. So foreign company having POEM in India, as far as my knowledge, there is no such concept. So an Indian company floats a company outside India, and us company ka place of effective management India ke andar hota hai. Okay. So India company ka jo foreign company subsidiary bani hai, uska POEM hota hai. This will be considered as a resident company in India and would be taxed as not as a foreign company but as a resident Indian company. So that's the difference between a foreign company having POEM in India and foreign company having PE in India. I hope that it, you know, I was able to give you some pretext on some idea on that. So a foreign company having PE in India is an inward concept. Foreign company having POEM in India is an outward concept, basically. Can you explain the rule 3CA? Can you explain how weighted average is calculated in Excel with an illustration? That would actually require some calculation with the, but 10CA, you know, gave an example that you have to use weighted average, and if there are certain condition, you use it in such manner. If there are certain condition, if you use it in that manner. So I think this will go into very much detail, and therefore I would right now, you know, permit me to skip it up. I'll you know, personally you can mail me up and we can have a chat and I'll explain you you know for the greater benefit of the whole you know audience over there. Okay, China company normally offer incentive to manager of company who place import order with them. Okay. How will this manager can receive this income in his personal account, and what will be his tax compliance? This is a very, very, you know, borderline query, Neetuji. This can go into you know, some kind of I would say non-compliance lawfully. This is wrong. Okay, but let's say those managers, if they are receiving amount in their bank account, okay, they have to show that this is an income which is earned outside India. These managers, I would believe, we are resident person only, and because they are resident, their global income is taxable, and once their global income is taxable, they have to be taxed on that income. You can term it as an other income, or if it's a regular transaction, you can term it as a business expense. I don't know how it will go, but these are you know, unlawful kind of transactions. So you know, still for unlawful transaction you need to pay tax. Okay, so that tax needs to be there. Okay, income and personal account, any which way will be taxed. As per section 195, as per section 195, any person making payment to non-resident, not being a company or to. Okay, very interesting question, and I was also intrigued by this. You know, any person payment to a non-resident, not being a company, or to a foreign company. Okay, let me, you know, bring my thoughts to it. Okay, a person making payment to a non-resident. Okay, so non-resident can have many form of company. You know, it can have It can have, you know, I would say, it can have a foreign company also. It can have a, I would say, a PE where it turns out to be resident also. Okay, and it can have a foreign company also. So if they would have written any person payment to a non-resident, okay, that would also would have sufficed and would have enlarged the section, I would say. Okay, and it goes with the definition of a company. So if you see, there is one point which I am missing the link on that. Okay, let me, you know, give, you know, ponder on thoughts on that, and I'll surely be back on it once, you know, I mean, there is one link which I'm missing currently, and I'll take it, you know, Mehul Kumar, I'll take it, this question, you know, in a later sense, I'll do it. I'll just find it out, you know, from that act and just see it while.
Yeah.
You are there? DTAA benefit can be obtained in case of payment to both resident, non-resident to foreign company. Sorry, Akshay, DTAA benefit can be obtained in case of payment by both resident, non-resident to a foreign company. Yes, so both resident or a non-resident, it can be there. A non-resident, you have to see which DTAA will be applied, because there could be a triangular situation. Okay, there could be a situation that non-resident from some other country, the income is taxable in India, and the non-resident to which he is paying is actually in some other country. So there would be a triangular situation which you need to see which DTAA to apply. I think Chaitanya took that in his presentation yesterday also. Okay. A foreign company having POAM in India can become a resident of India. Always is a resident of a country where the company is incorporated. Hence, there is a tiebreaker. So, will this be solved? Okay. Very, very interesting question, Sachet. Okay. A foreign company having POE in India can become a resident of India. Yes. You know, so a tiebreaker typically is used in a resident, in an individual criteria. Okay. And you have to go to see DTAA. What does it say about in a specific DTAA? What does it say about residentship of company? And then according take a strand. So then, you know, you need to decide it accordingly from a DTAA perspective. Dineet is saying you were going to share a questionnaire. No, we were, you know, about to take some questions which these guys are floating. So yeah, that.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, Chaitanya.
Actually, it's for a disconnect together. Yes, questionnaire is there. We have a questionnaire for applicability of master file documentation and country by country reporting. We will circulate within the group and share with the organizers. Correct?
Okay,
and if you want to, at the end, I will give us a view of that after this question ends around.
Okay, sure. So you want to pick up any of the questions which are floating around?
Actually,
we last 10 minutes more. You can write your questions and we'll take this up. Meanwhile, I'll just, you know, take that case on non-resident. This I'm getting a little confused on that. But this query you can take, Chaitanya. I'm getting a little confused on that.
Yeah, I'm unable to see the queries. So please read out.
So Mehul is asking that section 195, any person making payment to a non-resident, not being a company, or to the foreign company. Okay, so why foreign company? What is the relevance of foreign company over there?
So, can you take that?
In section 195, we are making a payment to a non-resident.
Not being a company or to a foreign company. So, why they would have not mentioned non-resident only? You know, why non-resident not being a company and then, you know, this thing?
Non-resident foreign company is covered. I think every sort of person is covered while we are paying to a non-resident and under 195, correct? And this foreign company and not being a this is a certain clause which in the act wants to remove or it has picked up, I think, some for some entities which like firm. So would you kindly tell exactly
So Naman? I think we both are missing in this one plot, and I think you know, Mehul, if you can write it us, you know, I'll surely, you know, Mehul,
if you can mail us or something, it would be better to understand.
We'll get back to offline. Okay, temporary import of equipment for display in an exhibition in India will income accrued in India. Temporary import, if it's a one-off transaction, there may not be a business connection in India. Temporary import of machinery, I don't know, will it come as a rental of an immovable property? No, it is a movable property. So I think it could be out of the tax net, majorly. I think so. You need to, you know, there is no business connection, obviously. So it will be out of the tax net, you know, only because of whatever you are saying. I'm just considering that the repercussion could be different, you know. Read it, you know, and whatever knowledge you have made you available, please apply that. Okay. If foreign supplier is a PE in India, then TDS will be deducted for import payment on what value and rate? If foreign supplier is a PE in India, let's say it's a company, so it will be a foreign company, then the TDS you have to see, you know, the 40% whatever surcharge, that TDS would be deducted on the payment to be made.
Please pardon?
No, a foreign company has a PE in India. If you're making payment to that, then a TDS will be deducted on that
40%. Correct. Perfect. 40%. It's a foreign company, the 40%. Other than foreign company, then accordingly the rate will be varied. Next.
Yeah. Any question you want to pick up? I'm just going through other. Achha, you are not able to see the question.
Yeah, I am not able to see.
So it happens with the technology. Please explain the transaction covered under independent personal service. So Arpit, your question is very, very valid, and it's want to take Chetan, independent personal service?
Independent personal services are basically the professional services, we can say, which normally are covered under Article 16. Quoting correct, Naman. Article 16 is independent personal services generally, and like independent is we are taking consultancy of a third person, which is not an employee. We are not taking the employee-employer relationship benefits from that person, but we are taking a consultancy sort of. He is independent of us and providing the services or to the entity or to our entity or to the assessee. So that would be considered as independent personal services. Anything else you want to add?
There is a lot of confusion when it comes to whether it is a technical service or an independent personal service. So I think your query must have, you know, originated from that. What happens is this is a very fine line, and I'm telling you, independent personal service, if my memory serves me correct, OECD has removed that article from around 2009 or 10, because this is, you know, exactly like your, let's say, business service or anything. So let's say if hyper technically you are into a, you know, an independent personal services, were originally to more towards when people are doing their work independently, like a proprietorship or a partnership. Okay, so when a proprietorship partnership was there, then it was considered more as an independent personal services, and dependent personal services come on a salary basis, okay, on an employment basis. And so this independent personal services, there are many cases, there always a dichotomy between fees for technical services versus independent personal services. So you first see that whether your transaction falls exactly into fees for technical services. So there could be some independent personal services, let's say installation of machinery, okay, or a uninstallation of machinery, okay, and which is not a very technical service, khali nut bolt karna hai, but an individual person is doing that, okay, that can come into independent personal service. It may not come into technical service, and it may come into independent personal service. So that is a distinction. It will come into business also, and independent personal services will not be taxable in India unless PE is in India, okay. So independent personal service, something which is an independent person is doing it individually, or a proprietorship partnership, and not a technical service, is an independent personal service. I hope I have been able to answer your question.
I would just read it out. Article 15, para second of that Article 15 of US and Indo-US DTAA. The term professional services include independent scientific, literary, artistic, educational, or teaching activities, as well as the independent activities of physicians, surgeons, lawyers, engineers, architects, dentists, and accountants. So this is also says includes. This is also inclusive. So it can include others too, but depending on our professional judgment, we have to identify and apply the articles accordingly. Correct, Naman? Next question.
One question that Rithi has asked is that for a small practitioner, how to grow our TV practice? Very, very nice question. I think I'll throw 1 minute light on that, and Chaitanya can also throw light. So, you know, I would say that you have to approach, and as said in the starting, majorly referral clients you will get. Okay. Software, yes, cost is very high. Okay. So partner with people, okay, who already have software. Okay. And many of our clients, what they do some the TP study themselves, but get the search process done from us. So that is also a model which is applicable. So you can find, you know, in your vicinity, people who are, you know, having the already software. And so they can, you know, on some professional basis, they can give you the software search. Okay. Remember one thing, you know, let's take an example of Deloitte. Deloitte in Hyderabad has a world over transfer pricing benchmark BPO service in India. So duniya mein kahin bhi benchmarking hoti hai na, wo Deloitte mein yahan pe wo log poochte hain, yahan se karke de dete hain. So a third person can also conduct that search if you can make him understand the FAR aur usko agar aap bata sako typical step. So then you can arrange the cost. So like, you know, Chaitanya has Capital Line, somebody would have ACP, I would have Provis. You can contact these people and then, you know, they can you know, prepare search for you, and accordingly cost can be saved. So if I don't have a global software, so I contact people who have global software, pay them some amount, and then we do that work. Okay, so this can be done, and obviously speak in various forums and try to get niche work, and yes, maintain the price, because if you go into cost war into this, you will bleed. You will not be able to give professional justice. So Chaitanya, your take.
So I'll just repeat, the question is about increasing our practice, correct?
Yes.
SMP's practice. So I'll as you rightly pointed out, the referral practice is the best practice for professionals like us who are dealing into international taxation, transfer pricing, and in fact along with referral we just want have to build faith for long term purposes. So we must, as explained by Naman also on first day, that we must have to work anonymously. The work is done by the person who has referred to us the client, but that is to be, the picture should be seen like this by the client, that the client. So we don't for such reference also we have to build a faith, and it will come over the time. Over the time it comes, passage of time. And second is updation and networking is very important. And updations like we are having a webinar now, and various articles, Bombay Chartered Accountant Journal, CTC's journal is there, the Chambers journal, and various journals across the globe are there. Online articles you can go through and update your knowledge. And you also have networking skills. How much you can networking skills depend more on the person individually, how they network with the other professionals, like using WhatsApp or technology or Facebook or some LinkedIn is very, very good example for technical social presence. And last is articles and webinar. If we are able to understand, like the article on master file and country by country, I thought as a layman that main agar businessman hu to mereko ye kaise lagega. So various questions came across my mind, and that article I wrote in question answer form, when this would be applicable, how would it be applicable, how to calculate the various limits which are applicable, which accounting period has to be seen or financial period has to be seen, and all those questions I have jotted down and answered through my updations and discussions with, at various forums and various professionals, friends. So this would help a lot, and articles into the various journals, also at various websites, would also help to increase your coverage. So these are few points from my side. Yes, Naman, next, if you can go through.
Yeah, so you know, should we carry on, you know, or you know, because I think most of the questions I think have been exhausted now, and it's already 5:20. So maybe if somebody has any question, suggestion, comments, your suggestion for improvements, or maybe question, you know, we may, you know, I think we can hand over to Virag and
yeah.
And question whatever your comment, suggestion, anything, please do share over this platform. You know, we are there for next 2-3 minutes. So, you know, we'd be happy to know your comments, suggestions, and yes, we'd be happy to connect also. You know, on various platforms like LinkedIn.
Yeah, yeah.
So Virag, Abhishek,
we are very thankful to all of you, and hope you have got or we have justified the with the topics we have taken, or taken the responsibility properly to explain the transfer pricing and international taxation concepts. So thank you all, thanks a lot.
Virag and Abhishek, anybody is there?
Virag,
thank Abhishek. You so much, Naman ji and Chaitanya ji. Yeah, so I'm watching since continuously. You both are giving continuously answer of all the queries. I don't think so there is unanswered question any. So we are very thankful to you, and we hope that you will continue to come on our platform and engaging the members. This will help in long term to all the members who have taken part in this series, how to start a international practice, international taxation practice from scratch. So this will very helpful to you. So again, once more, I would like to thank you all the participants and both of you, our panelists. Thank you so much, Naman bhai, Chaitanya ji. And we are ending webinar thank right you, away everyone. Here for this series. Thank you all.
Take care, everyone.
Yes, thank you, Naman bhai, and thank you, Chaitanya ji.
Thank you all.